The next one is a large retail organization. And this is kind of interesting because back in 2013, this organization was the very first organization I actually did present IT4IT to. I didn't do much with it, right? I didn't actually stay with that company and work with them on a day-to-day basis. It was more or less presented it and walked away and did other things, right? Now, you know, they were pretty competent. And what I found out in 2015, end of 2015, was that they did some pretty miraculous things with IT4IT. They changed their entire operating model for their IT shop. So what I will show you is sort of what came out of that, what I learned, and they started to communicate to their vendors that they wanted their vendors to map their stuff to IT4IT. What is it for? Why is it there? You know, can you qualify that? And this is basically what they did, and they internalized it, just similar to what Rick talked about earlier. They internalized it and they created their own sort of view and branding for IT4IT. And you'll notice that build and acquire was changed, right? It used to be just build. They said, you know, we don't want to just build our services, we want to acquire them too. And they added an executive direction layer, which they said that's really their strategy process. And then their support layer, which are also very similar to what IT4IT describes. So they changed it around, they mapped it to what they actually are doing. And another piece of information about this, there's a little bit of feedback that did come in while I was supporting. You know, once in a while I would get a call from this company, they would ask a few questions. Mark, what does this mean? Oh, I'll explain it to him. Or if I didn't know what that function meant or a certain thing, element of the standard meant, I would ask some of the peers, right, the folks that are in this room even, and say, hey, what, you know, where is this function? Why isn't this represented in the standard? And get some good answers. And some of that feedback that in that dialogue, even though they're not here, they're not public, that feedback and that dialogue still came through me, and you'll see there were some changes made to the standard as a result. So some of the change, the lesson learned, okay, is that we may not know the use cases that are happening now that the standard is out there in the wild. I think the best stories are still to be discovered, to be honest. But this was a very interesting one, and I think it took 2 years to kind of see this kind of result, but it shows you the sort of the value and how it got institutionalized within companies.